dun 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 da ba 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 boodly boo baitum ba ba wooble wobble. The Evolutionary History of the Honey Badger by Liam McAllister.
Mellivora capensis, better known as the honey badger, is an interesting organism. The honey badger, despite its name, actually looks more like a stretched out weasel than a badger. If you ask me, it doesn't even look like an animal. Ugh! Look at that face. I still have the nightmares. Maybe after seeing the video, you wondered why the honey badger didn't care about anything. Well, that's due to its amazing defensive capabilities. It doesn't have to worry about anything. That thing can take a hit, or 1,000 bee stings. Your choice. The honey badger is a native to sub-Saharan Africa, Southwest Asia, and the Indian subcontinent. The honey badger is a member of the Mustelidae family. Some early mustelids consist of fishers. No, not those kinds of fishers. No, not that either. Yeah, there we go. The oldest known species of fishers were just recently found in the Rattlesnake Formation of Oregon, the bones of which were dated to be 5 million years before the colonization of America. The mustelids are a part of the Carnivora order, who date back to 55 million years ago. The honey badger became a native to dry and arid lands, and so it evolved to be more defensively capable. It adapted to get some thick skin to survive in the desert. This thing is so hardcore that the IUCN Red List for Endangered Species rated it an LC, Least Concern. The early mustelids were not as strong defensively and were more preyed upon, yet they lived in an environment where there were not as many concerns. The weasel, the honey badger's cousin, isn't as strong either, but it doesn't have many predators. So you must be asking, wait, how does artificial selection affect your species? Oh, you aren't? Well, to be honest, I probably wouldn't either if I didn't have to do this project. Anyway, the honey badger's adapted better to the desert than other biomes. If it went to the forest where the weasel's at, it wouldn't be as agile and might not be able to find food. It wouldn't need the defensiveness that it has at the moment, and would probably be just die out because it can't eat and chase the prey. The weasel and the honey badger of butt-kicking awesomeness are closely related due to their features and ancestors. They both evolved from fishers and mustelids, claws for killing inferior species, and a similar spinal structure that allows them to kill these inferior species because without it they wouldn't even be able to stand up and run after the prey. But the honey badger, 100 years from now, deserts are drying up more and more every year. In 100 years, the honey badger may have to grow a camel's hump to store water. If the desert keeps drying up, they will need more water and won't have a way to keep it in storage. So forget saving the trees and pandas. Who needs pandas? The honey badger is so much better, and we should save the deserts and save this amazing beast of a creature.